Boink. Hello everyone, welcome back. So we have two more crystals to get in this warp room. Let's get on with it, I think. Really? Oh, there's some stuff. What was the stuff? Now, considering the other one was behaving and this one is digging it, they ought to be named the other way around, because this one has less of the digging. Now these guys you can destroy with a belly flop. Yes. There's much less of the digging in this one, considering it's called digging it. No bees so far. No bees at all so far. Oh, here we go. Yeah. Whatever. Fed up with these spitter bugs. Oh, balls to it. Sneaky crate up there. Ah, now. Hang on. No. Let's try that again. Can I actually reach that? That's the question. Not if I miss the box entirely. I feel like I can. Oh, come on. It's gotta be possible. Fluff that. I'm not gonna make it now. Or am I? No, I'm not. What the hell was that? Seriously, how am I failing to get on top of this one now? Really? Oh. There are lives up there. That appears to be it. I mean, I'll take them. It's great. This, I think it is possible to get the gem from the end of the route without going that way, because you can jump back from the other side. The interesting question is, are there crates in that path? The answer is probably yes. Dare I risk it? Let's just check it out. Nitros galore. Oh god. That's unforgiving. And yeah, I can see a crate in the corner there. That just happened. Okay, I don't think I'm going that way without a mask, really. Nothing sneaky up there, okay. Timing is everything. Nope. Nope. Ugh. You sneaky bugger. But yeah, it's called Digging It, and there hasn't been a single dig patch yet. Oh! There's a dig patch. Yeah, how far into the level am I now? And you've got the first dig patch. And it's called Digging It. Yeah. Honestly, I think maybe... Although there were a lot more bees in the other one than this one as well, so... The name was kind of... Both apply best to the other level. It's one of those things. Yeah, sod it. Not interested. Yeah, so here's the other end of the gem route. Could totally make that. Can totally, totally make that. Honest, it's because the camera angle's really awkward for it. Well, that time I just failed to jump. I'm sure this is possible. Yeah, the mask's gonna make no difference to anything. I could backtrack using my mask, but I'll probably lose it. I'll keep going until I'm down to 30 lives and then I'll give up. Oh, hello. Oh, okay, that's the way to do it. Unless you do that. Jump! No, I'm not stopping now because I've ascertained the method. I jumped! Oh, oops. Check me out. Yeah. Gem. Gem. I mean, I still need to actually do the secret route in order to get the crates that are in it. But, you know. I'll take a free gem. So there are 7 non-nitro crates. Right, I'm just going to check out what the other thing I wanted to mention was, because I'm sure there was something. No, I don't know what. So let's just carry on. I mean, I can talk about Cold Hard Crash and the fact that it's the highest crate count of any level in the Mission Trilogy. Oh! Like, surely hitting the rat from that side would. No, it wouldn't. No, it would not. So, really, the trick here is just to skip over entirely, really. Really? That didn't get you. That did get me. Underjumped. Seriously. A mask, that's nice. Probably because these are all going to be nitros. Seriously. Green gem platform, here we go. This is the first colour gem platform I've done. No, I think I did blue. Look at this, it hardly goes anywhere. I kept preempting them too much. That was more luck than anything else. Oh. Also, that rain is really loud. Could this cross over much slower? I mean, it's hardly going anywhere, for goodness sake. Oh, almost. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna I'm just gonna complete the levels and get the crystals for now. Let's leave the gems for post game. Again, a bonus round where you're not actually that far from the main level. With the bouncy crates. Flawless! Now there is a gem with crates. This is not one of the levels you can do it in. But there are a couple of levels where the bonus platform gets back to the main level so quickly that you actually get back before all the crates have finished counting in from the bonus. And that means you can get, like, extra. If you die before they finish counting. Then you can get more crates than there actually are in the level, which also means you can get the gem without getting all of the crates. Which is a funny thing. Well, I've lost that. Oh, look at the tilty platform. Just to make things interesting. Also goes really slowly. Okay, let's try this again. Oh god. Should have looked before I leapt. That's the correct timing for that. Okay. Boink. Can't believe I didn't die doing that. Thank you. try this again, shall we? Oh, I overdid it! I might be better off going for the checkpoint. Nailed it. And that's the end. Which means all the crates in the gem route are nitros. Hello, Cortex.
Hirsch, I have discovered that the opposition is being masterminded by Dr. Nectris Brio, the inventor of the Evolvo Ray. Brio was responsible for our misunderstandings in the past. He forced me to assist him in his plot for world domination, and nice. He's at it again. He will attempt to stand in our way. Be on your guard, Crash. Use the platform to deliver the crystals to Engine.
No.
Like Dr. Cortex said, if the 20 crystals you've collected from me.
What, are you going to collect the last 5? Who knew that fruit was such a lethal weapon? They don't even have to be fired out of a bazooka. Okay, 3 hit points left. Side, that side, okay. Which side? That side, no problem. It's just a matter of stand still, get a few hits in, and then move. Fairly straightforward. Bye bye. The Wrath of Cortex. That's not until 2 games away. If you're only counting the platformer ones.
What is your problem, Bandicoot? I will not ask you again to bring me the crystals! Obtain the remaining 5 crystals, Crash, and bring them to me.
So here we are, in the final warp room. We have pistons, jetpack levels, night fight, which is, I think, one of those Firefly ones, another jetpack one, and another piston one, I think. I'm going to go into here. Oh, okay, you can't hit the top of those. I thought you probably could. These things, right. Sparky tentacle bot things. In the code, apparently, these guys are called Fred. Which I think is just great. They're just called Fred. Of course, those ones are harmless, you just jump on them. They get smarter in a little while. Still just these guys. Timing was not in my favour there. There we go, there's the smarter ones. Well, these are the ones with the sparks on the top. The smart ones that, yeah, there we go. The ones that mix it up. That's quite a leap. That's almost certainly hot. There's the crystal. This is going to be fun. I'm going to have to jump over into the gap and then skip. There we go. I've already died in this level, so no death route for me. What does this thing do? Nothing at the moment, apparently. Ah, yes. I'd forgotten about those. Oh, Jesus Christ, how did that not... Oh, this is going to be fun. To leave you there. And I fell. I need something so I can... Unless... I can't see a nitro explosion crate. Oh, balls to it. This presumably is the end of the bonus round. So I'm not going to go that way yet. But I'm still going to get past the nitros. That's going to be... I can try. Oh, what a master. It's like, can I edge along the platform? Yes, I can. Masterful, masterful. Because I'm going to go back the other way normally because I'm not risking that again. Falling off or hitting nitros being the two options for how it could easily go wrong. I was like, I should wait, and I didn't. Well, that was just... Let's try this again, shall we? Yeah, I don't think I can jump over that crate to get to the piston. Oh, for the love of Bandicoot. Sod it, I'll try the edge trick again. It's actually not that difficult, it's just nerve-wracking. But this time... Let's make it to the end. I mean, if there's a single crate in the death route, then I'm wasting my effort anyway. But they definitely didn't recycle the here in which one, the Wall of China levels in Warped. I mean, it's not difficult, it's just mildly threatening. Okay, this is going to be a sequence of events. Not a particularly difficult one. Oh, there are loads in the secret area. Well, that is going to be it for this episode. If you've enjoyed the video, remember to leave a like, share a favourite and comment, help support the channel. Follow me on Twitter to stay up to date with what's going on, and subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks for watching, and next time there's a good chance of me completing the storyline. We'll see. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.